Williams, Brother Minister, amen. Joshua Williams, amen. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise God. And then we will have our greetings. Mother Ward, amen. Let's say praise the Lord as they come in that order. If you love him, say yes.
Thank you. obstacles. lift those hands if you've got two hands. Lift those hands if you've got two hands. Lift those hands. I hear the Holy Ghost. This time of surrender is going to be the moment that things change in your life. This is going to be the moment that God releases that thing that you've been waiting for all year long. There are some of you who came here tonight willing and ready for God to release into your womb the thing that He has been promising you all year long. But I hear the Holy Ghost. Somebody shout, tonight is your night, Tamashiv. Tonight is your all, Tamashiv.
I just keep hearing that in my spirit. Deliverance comes to those.
those who desire. Deliverance comes to those who desire. He's going to lift something off you tonight. Come here, Mama. I don't even know what the issue is, but I know I heard God. God's going to lift it off you tonight. He's going to lift the burden that you've been carrying. There's a burden you've been carrying for a long time. God said, tonight I came that he can lift it, not me, but him. He said he came so that he can lift it. He came so that you might have life and that you may have more abundantly. I even hear God say that the issue in the verdict that you've been carrying has diminished your lifestyle. It has diminished your quality of life. But I hear God say that tonight, now.
Because he deserves it. Yes.
irrespective of the conditions. Because the truth of the matter is that many of us worship God based on how we feel. Okay, y'all gonna leave me out there by myself. But I know what I'm talking about. We worship God based on how we feel. You know, I feel like doing it tonight. I feel like worshiping tonight. I feel like praising tonight. I feel like, but is there anybody who say, you know what, I'll take these hands. Oh Lord. And in my tired body, listen to this. In my tired body, in my feeble mind, in my back hurt, in my legs hurt, in my head hurt, I will bless the Lord.
Somebody said it's in my mind.
But the scripture says that thou ought to let this mind be in me.
Yes.
Which was also in Christ. And I promise you, if you'll take off your mind and put on his mind, you'll be surprised what your mind will do.
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, it's all in your mind.
It's all in your mind.
Pastor Gary, I'm looking at my money, and I don't have the money to make it. It's all in your mind. Because the Bible says that he will supply all of your need,
yes.
Lord have mercy, according to his riches.
Yes.
Not yours, but his.
Yes.
It's in my mind. It's in my mind. It's in my mind. And the moment your mind is renewed is the moment that God releases himself from me. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Let me give you this right quickly. Luke chapter number 7. Lord have mercy. Come on back. Luke chapter number 7, verse number 11 through 15. I know I've had you for a while, but if you'll just stand for the word of God, I promise you I'm going to read this right quick and then you can sit down. Amen. Luke chapter number 7, verse number 11 through 15. Somebody say, speak Holy Ghost.
Speak Holy Ghost.
And it came to pass. My favorite 5 words in the Bible.
Yeah.
Because it didn't come to stay. It didn't come to stay. It came to.
Jesus.
That the day after, he went into a city called Nain. Many of his disciples went with him, and much people. And when he came nigh to the gate of the city, behold, there was a dead man carried him. Son of his mother. She was a widow. And much people of the city was with her. I came to tell somebody that you've been going through some things and everybody's been able to see it. But those same people that saw you in a bad place are going to be the people that's going to see you come through in your good place. Alright, I ain't getting nobody here. But I came to, maybe I'm preaching to myself, Gary, I came to tell you that a lot of people have seen you fail. But those same people I can see you succeed, they have received that word of the Lord is going on. When the Lord saw her, he had compassion on her and said of her, girl, what's wrong with you? Stop all that crying.
Yes.
He came and touched the bier, the casket, the coffin, and they that bare him stood still and said, young man, I say unto thee, arise. And he that was dead, Lord have mercy to you. And he that was dead, somebody say was dead. He that was dead sat up and began to speak, and he delivered him to his mother. I came to preach to somebody tonight, and I want you to take this as being the word of the Lord over your own life. Somebody shout and say, I'm coming back better.
I'm coming back better.
Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Somebody shout, I'm coming back better. You can say this loud enough. Somebody shout, I'm coming back better. Jesus. You've been down way too long. Lord have mercy. You've been worrying too long. You've been stressing too long. But the word of the Lord on your life is not just for tonight. It's not this, but it's for the duration of your entire life. Okay? Let me make sure that I make this clear. Because here's what happens. Many of us, oh God, superintendent, I love you. And I, first of all, can we give God praise for the man of God? Come on, let's have our hands. Amen. It's the first lady. God bless you, everybody. Amen. But here's been the problem. The problem has been that you and I have treated church like crap. Can I talk right there just for a moment? We treated it like crap. I'm going to church tonight because I got to get my fix. I'm going to church tonight because I need a word from the Lord. I'm going tonight to church because I need to be delivered in my mind. And I'm not saying that none of those things aren't true. What I am telling you is, if you will submit yourself to the power of God that's in this house tonight, you will never have another problem of that sort.
Hallelujah.
Okay. I never said you wouldn't have another problem at all. I said that when you get your mind right, y'all know what I'm saying? When you get your mind right, you can get your mind right. What ends up happening is, you don't need nobody to come lay no hands on you. You lay hands on yourself. You won't need another prophet in your life. You prophesy to your own. You won't need a doctor. You say, by his stripes. Somebody shout, I am healed. Problem has been that we've been down.
Yes.
Long.
Yes.
Damn, nigga, I'm coming back then.
Listen
to this. For some of us, the task has been too great. The weight has at times seemed to be too much that we can bear. For some of you, the totality of your circumstances has caused you to die. Pastor Jarvis, I don't know about you, but being a prisoner in my mind is worse than being a prisoner in somebody's jail. Because at least if I'm a prisoner in jail, right, somebody can come and open up the door because they have the key. But the truth of the matter is, when you are a prisoner in your own mind, it is difficult for you to utilize the key that God already said belongs to you. I know I'm talking to somebody. But what ends up happening is, you fool yourself into believing that it shouldn't be this way for you. You fool yourself into believing that you can do no better, that you can't be no better, that you can't drive in better. You know we can't do no better because we from Palatka. No, no, the truth of the matter is, I don't care what's going on in this city, you belong to God.
That's right.
I'm preaching better than y'all saying amen. The truth of the matter is that many of us have been down for so long. Listen to this. That we have been made to believe that that's the way it should be.
Amen.
That's not the word of the Lord over your life.
That's right.
Let me tell you this. I came to realize this, Mama, right? That many of us come to church not because we have a relationship with God, but because we need to anesthetize our pain.
Oh my God.
We need to anesthetize our pain.
Right.
It hurts so bad. I lost this. And I lost that. And this died around me. And that, am I talking to anybody in this room? This has died around me. And that has died around me. And all I can do is come here and at times jump and shout and pray that the pastor says something that makes me feel better. But I came to tell you, you don't need a word from God. You need to activate what's already in you. Okay. All right. Somebody shout, he's talking to me.
He's talking to me.
I want to ask you this, because many of you, like this man in the scripture, he chose to die. What? He chose to die. Listen to this. This man did not do what King Hezekiah did. He didn't turn his face to the wall and tell God, God, I can't praise you from the grave. I can't worship you from the grave. So if you do something for me, I need you to bring my life back. He never one time did that. He never even did what Lazarus did. He didn't send word to Jesus and say, Jesus, I'm sick. Never one time did he send a text message, an email, a Facebook message, a Twitter, a tweet. okay to die? Who gave you permission to die? Who told you that it was okay for you to go to sleep? Because the Bible says, now I don't know about the Bible that you read in Palatka, but I know about the Bible that I read in Melbourne, and my Bible says that Jesus came that I might have what? Oh, y'all read the same Bible. He came that we might have what? And have what? More abundantly. But here's what's crazy. If you go back in the text, Lord have mercy. Tell your neighbor, you got to read the text. You got to read the text. Say it loud. Say, you got to read the text. You got to read the text. Listen. If you go back and you read the text, verse number 12 says that he was the only son of his mother, and she was a widow.
That's right.
Which means that he was the provision in the house. Some of you are the person that everybody depends on.
Amen.
But you've decided to die. Mm. And I want to ask you, who told you it was okay for you to die? I'm telling you right now, when I die, I'm going to die empty.
Yeah.
And I'm going to die fighting. Death is going to have to come and get me and chase me down and make me submit, because I've already made up in my mind that I'm going to run to Jesus and say, come on.
Yeah.
Yes.
You're right.
Yeah.
Somebody shout amen to that.
Amen.
But the truth of the matter is that Jesus had a different expression that he wanted to have through this boy. Listen at this. Let me tell you what you really should be saying when it is that you find yourself going through. Because the truth of the matter is, most of us in this room will say, I got something that I'm dealing with. Is there anybody in this room say, I got something? Somebody said, I got something I'm dealing with. Listen at this. But Joel 3:10 says this: be your plowshares into swords, Lord have mercy, and your pruning hooks into shears, and let the weak say, I am
strong.
Lord have mercy. The truth of the matter is, if you are strong, you will tell death, you don't have a right to come and get me. You don't have the right to come and do something to me. You don't have the right to come and take my life. Somebody shout, no, sir. All right, y'all. Listen, I don't know what's hot. Listen, but I got on a black suit and some underclothes. You listen to this. I need somebody in this house to shout, no, sir.
No, sir.
I didn't come here to die. I came here to live.
Yes.
2 Corinthians 4:17 says, well, this light affliction,
yeah,
which is but for a moment,
yeah,
is for a moment. Somebody shout, for a moment.
Uh-huh.
Working for us a far more exceeding and eternal way of glory. I can't, yeah, tell you that what you're going through right now may seem like it's hurting you, but it's going to push you into your eternity.
Yeah.
Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Listen to this. I came to tell you tonight that when you bounce back from this one, Lord have mercy, then the weight is going to come up off your shoulders. Lord have mercy. God's going to release the glory on your life, but you got to make up in your mind that you are not going to die.
Yes.
Tell your neighbor, I'm not going to die. Say it, say, I'm not going to die. It's like this. There's an old song you sang back in the day that says, because he lives. Oh, Jesus. I can face tomorrow. Because he lived. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying? All fear is gone because I know who holds my future and my life. Somebody shout, my life is worth it.
My life is worth it.
Somebody shout, my life is worth it.
My life is worth it.
Your life is worth living because he lives. Now this text is a living text, and it's alive because Jesus has entered into the scene. It was after Jesus had healed a centurion's servant that we find him in the city of Nain. Listen to this.
Yeah.
Find him in the city of Nain, which interpreted, Nain, interpreted and translated means plush and beautiful and opulent and gorgeous, etc. Listen to this. But yet in a beautiful place, Jesus finds a woman going through a dark situation. I want to know, have you come to church, the place where everything should be good, but it seems like it's all falling apart?
Yeah.
Have you ever gone to home? Look, listen to this. If you can't get no respite anywhere else, if you can't get any consolation anywhere else, I should be able to go to where I lay my head and everything should be okay. But I don't know about you. God for my wife. I've got a good wife. My wife better than your wife. Okay, all right. Listen. I came to tell somebody. I came to tell somebody that God has come tonight to let you know that your life is not over. And that your dying is illegal. Tell your neighbor, say neighbor. Whatever you do, don't die of a legal death. Say it again, say whatever you do, don't you die an illegal death. Lord, I gotta get out of here. Listen to this. Listen to this. I came to tell you this, that this praise that you're about to give God right now is for those of you who are encountering horrible situations. Lord have mercy. And what should be the most beautiful time in your life? Listen to this. The children are gone. Hallelujah. But the husband just left you. Lord have mercy. The children are gone, and it seems like everything that you have built up in your life is walking away from you. Lord have mercy. You were 2 payments away from paying off the house, and then you got laid off on your job, and now you lost your house. A beautiful place. Going through a dark situation. Oh my God. Am I talking to anybody in this house? Listen to this. But listen to this. The praise sends the signal to the devil that you may have hurt me real bad. Oh, have mercy. Let me say it to you again. The praise. Somebody talk to praise. Sends a signal to the devil that you should have killed me before I got to church. Now I got to church. And there's a word that came to bless my life. Somebody clap your hands and give God praise right now. Jesus finds this woman crying and weeping in a beautiful place. Somebody shout, Jesus finds this woman crying where she should have been praising. He finds this woman crying where she should have been laughing. Jesus finds this woman crying where she should have been waving her hands. But I came to tell somebody that just because you're crying,
on the boy. My.
who will say, I can't do it unless the preacher lay his hands on me. Never one time do we see Jesus lay his hands on a boy. Because I'm going to tell you this, I'm convinced in my mind that I don't always need Jesus to lay his hands on me. I need him to lay his hands on the crazy stuff I'm doing.
That's right.
Came up singing a song where they said, what more can he do? What more can he do? Lay the foundation.
That's right.
Open up the way.
Mama.
What more? I know you've already done it, but can I get you to lift your hands for me just a moment? I'm telling you, if you leave here tonight, not experiencing life on the level that God has put us in design, it's not because of a lack of work. It's not because of a lack of the anointing. It's not because of a lack of power. It's due to a lack of tonight. We want to help your faith to be empowered.
Yes, 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 yes.
So everybody with a faith deficiency, I want you to come flood this altar right quick. If you've got a vitamin F